Good morning students. In this lecture 44th of electronics, we will discuss our next topic, which is voltage multiplier circuits. As the name indicates, voltage multiplier circuits are the circuits which will multiply the voltage, input voltage, or which increase the input voltage by a number of times of it. So it is the type of the diode rectifier circuit which can produce an output voltage many times greater than that of applied input voltage. So these voltage multiplier circuits, they will be used to maintain low transformer peak voltages by stepping up the peak output to 2, 3, 4 or more times than that of peak of rectified voltage. It means we can multiply the peak of the rectified voltage by any number of times. Now these voltage multiplier circuits, they are of many types: voltage doubler, voltage tripler, voltage quadrupler. And voltage doubler, it is of two types: half wave voltage doubler and full wave voltage doubler. And voltage tripler and quadrupler, so we will discuss them one by one. So first, in this video, we are going to discuss half wave voltage doubler and full wave voltage doubler. So what is half wave voltage doubler? Here we have a transformer. This is the primary coil of the transformer. This is the core of the transformer. This one is the secondary coil of the transformer. And one end of the secondary coil of the transformer, it is connected to the capacitor. Then it is connected to this capacitor C1. It is connected to P of diode, and negative terminal of the diode D1, it is connected to the other end of the secondary coil. And then diode D2 is connected with this polarity, and it is further connected to capacitor C2. And in case of half-wave voltage doubler, output V out, it is taken across only one capacitor, that is C2. But in case of full wave voltage doubler, output will be taken across two capacitors. So as the name indicates that this is voltage doubler, it means our output voltage, it will be the twice of the peak voltage of input. And what is the peak voltage of input? That is plus Vm. So our output must be equal to plus 2 Vm in this case. So in case of voltage doubler, we will use diode capacitor circuit. In case of voltage doubler, we will use two diodes and two capacitors. In case of voltage tripler, we will use three diodes and three capacitors. Similarly, in voltage quadrupler, we will use four diodes and four capacitors. In case of voltage doubler, our output will be plus 2 Vm, means it will get doubled than the peak of the input voltage. Then in case of voltage tripler, our output will be plus 3 Vm, means it will be the thrice of the peak of input voltage. Then in case of voltage quadrupler, our output will be 4 times the peak of the input voltage, means it will be plus 4 Vm. So first we will discuss half wave voltage doubler. So how the output gets doubled? So in this case, consider this AC input signal which you will apply here. So during the first positive half cycle of AC input, the polarity of the circuit, it will be like this on the secondary coil. Now this polarity, this positive sign, it will make this diode D1 forward biased, and this positive, as it is connected to negative of D2, so during the positive half cycle, diode D2, it will be reverse biased. So we are assuming that both the diodes are ideal diodes. So diode D2, as it is reverse biased, so it will act as open circuited, and diode D1, as it is forward biased, so it will act as short circuited. So we will draw this circuit again. So during the first positive half cycle, this circuit will be like this. Diode D1 is short circuited, diode D2 is, as it is reverse biased, so it will be open circuited. So during the first positive half cycle, what will happen? This capacitor C1, it will charge through diode D1 to peak value plus Vm. And now we will show that how this capacitor, it charges to peak value plus Vm. So to calculate the voltage over this capacitor C1, apply Kirchhoff's voltage law and suppose that voltage across this C1, it is Vc1. So apply Kirchhoff voltage law here. So how it will be? It will be plus Vm voltage here. So here we must have alternate sign, but the signs are plus minus. So this is plus Vm, then the signs are not alternate, so it will be minus Vc1. It is equal to zero. So Vc1 is equal to plus Vm. It means the capacitor C1, it will be charged to peak of the input voltage, that is plus Vm, during the first positive half cycle. Then during the first negative half cycle of AC input, what will happen? Now during the first negative half cycle of AC input, the polarity over the secondary coil, it will be reversed. So now upper end is negatively charged, lower end is positively charged. So this will make diode D1 reverse biased. So diode D1 will be open circuited and diode D2 forward biased, means it will be short circuited during the first negative half cycle. So now as this diode, as this capacitor C1, it will not be discharged during the negative half cycle. Why? Because it is not getting any path for its discharging. Capacitor C1 doesn't get any discharging path because diode D1 is reverse biased and it is acting as open circuited. So this capacitor C1, it will act as a source voltage. It will act as a voltage source of voltage plus Vm. So this plus minus, it means both are in series. So now this capacitor C2, it will charge via this diode D2 up to a voltage of plus 2 Vm. Why? Because now we have total voltage of plus Vm and plus Vm, which is plus 2 Vm. So it will charge this capacitor C2 during the negative half cycle via this diode D2 to voltage plus 2 Vm. And now we will prove this by using Kirchhoff's voltage law. So apply Kirchhoff's voltage law here. It will be, see, this is, apply Kirchhoff's voltage law in this direction. So this is plus Vm. Then now why the polarity of capacitor C2 is in this way, upper end is negative, lower is positive? Because it is getting charged during the negative half cycle, and during the negative half cycle this lower end is positively charged. So that is why this end is connected to positive charge. It means this end will be positively charged and this end will be negatively charged, as it is connected to negative end of the coil. So we have, this is plus Vm, plus Vm, then sign is not alternate, so it will be minus V2. And then again sign is alternate, so it will be plus Vm. So plus Vm minus Vc2 plus Vm, so it is equal to zero. So Vc2 is equal to plus 2 Vm. So C2 will be charged to peak value, that is plus 2 Vm. Now during the next positive half cycle of AC input, again D1 will be forward biased and D2 will be reverse biased. Now if we will connect load resistance RL across C2, across only C2, so our output will be plus 2 Vm. So in this way the voltage is doubled, that is plus 2 Vm, that is twice the peak of the voltage at the secondary coil. So next we will discuss full wave voltage doubler. In case of full wave voltage doubler, we will take our output across the two capacitors C1 and C2. So this is the circuit of full wave voltage doubler. Again, as it is voltage doubler, so here we will have two diodes and two capacitors. And in the previous circuit as well as in this circuit, when you are starting to use these two capacitors, they must be discharged initially before using them. And again, assume that the diodes used are ideal ones. So during the first positive half cycle of AC input, the polarity will be like this. Upper end of the secondary coil will be positive. Lower end of the secondary coil will be negative. So this will make diode D1 forward biased, and diode, this positive terminal, it is connected to negative of D2. So diode D2 will be reverse biased during the first positive half cycle of AC input. So D1 will be short circuited and D2 will be open circuited. So our circuit will be like this. So during the first positive half cycle of AC input, in case of full wave voltage doubler, our circuit will be like this. And now apply Kirchhoff's voltage law here. Now, what will be the polarity of this capacitor? Suppose VC1 is the voltage, instantaneous voltage over the capacitor. As this plate, it is connected to positive terminal, so it will be positively charged. And this plate is connected to negative terminal, so it will be negatively charged. Now apply Kirchhoff's voltage law. It will be plus Vm minus VC1. Why? Because the signs are not alternate. So VC1, it will be plus Vm. So during the first positive half cycle of AC input, capacitor C1, it is getting charged to the peak value of the input voltage, that is plus Vm. Then during the next half cycle, that is negative half cycle, during the negative half cycle, the polarity will be like this. Upper end will become negatively charged, lower end will become positively charged, and it will reverse bias the diode D1. And this negative is connected to negative of D2, so it will forward bias the diode D2. So now the diode D2 is short circuited and D1 is open circuited. So this C1, it is not having any discharging path. Why? Because we have not connected any load resistor RL. So this C1, it is equal to plus Vm. It will stay as it is, because neither it has load resistor and nor it is having path here, because diode D1 is reverse biased. So C1 is not getting any discharge path during the negative half cycle of AC input. So now the capacitor C2, it will be charged to voltage plus Vm through D2 because of this plus Vm. How? This is the path. This is plus Vm. Plus minus. And how we have decided the polarity of the plates of the capacitor? As you can see, this upper plate, it is connected to positive terminal, so it will be positively charged. And this lower plate, it is connected to negative terminal, so it will be negatively charged. Now apply Kirchhoff's law here. This is, as you can see, this is, instead of plus, here we have minus sign. So we will use minus Vm. Then again minus means signs are not alternate. So we will have plus VC2. It is equal to 0. So VC2 will be equal to plus Vm. So during the negative half, capacitor C2, it is getting charged to peak value plus Vm. Now during the next half, connect load resistor RL of very high load resistance value and take the output across both the capacitors C1 and C2, and the voltage across capacitor C1 is Vm and voltage across capacitor C2 is Vm. So output will be Vm plus Vm, that is 2 Vm. So again the voltage gets doubled than the peak of the voltage on the secondary coil of the transformer. So in this way, we have discussed half wave voltage doubler and full wave voltage doubler in this video. And in the next lecture, we will discuss voltage tripler and voltage quadrupler. Means V0 is equal to plus 3 Vm and V0 is equal to plus 4 Vm.